Filthy Casual video. I am Filthy Casual and will be for life only because I've done the big rating thing, I've done the serious business thing, and it just got way too stressful for me. So I have nothing but respect for those who play the game seriously, those who are on live PvP and all that business, esports. You know, those guys really have a lot of respect from me because of the time that they are willing to invest in such a thing. And hey, they get paid in the shade when it comes down to it. So today we are in Borealis in Battle for Azeroth expansion pack. And I am on my recently upgraded, so his costume looks a little silly, Alliance Pandaren Hunter. And we are going to be doing pet, that is companion, pet upgrading. I've been collecting a lot of stones for upgrading from poor quality to high quality. And I actually have a registry at warcraftpets.com where the highest pet collection that's registered there, which may not be the highest in the whole game, is, you know, ranked on a scale with a score, and that is 7,327. There are two of them that are equal. Usually when you get two top players that are equal, it means they've done as much as possible. There's nothing more you could do. But I don't know if that is the case with these two individuals. If you go to warcraftpets.com, you can see it's public information, basically. So Rhias, R-H-I-A-S, and Ryken, R-Y-K-E-N, are the top two pet collectors with an equal score. I'm sure Rhias did something that made him or her, you know, some gender really listed there, the person who had the top score when their scores are both equal. But I'm sitting at 6,231. The top 500 collections, I would rank, even in that, I don't think so. No, I think to be the 500th in place, you'd have to be 70-50. And before all these stones I'm about to do, my score, as mentioned, was, which I got off the page, 6,231. So I've got some catching up to do, but I've just been neglecting my stones. And that's what we're going to do today. So we're going to stand here on this little rooftop, and we are going to whip out the stones, Dr. Lecter, and find out what my score becomes when I upgrade, and then re-upload my pet collection, update my pet collection. So let's get down to it. Let's get off of the open view and just have a nice little scene back here. And just ignore all the clutter. It's just my dominoes and, you know, got everything shut up that I possibly could. And let's have this little fellow come out. I named him Click for Beers. So when people walk by, they know if you click this little guy, you go and get some beers. And when you get some beers, which I thought I had a shortcut for this, but now I'll just make another one. Probably in here somewhere. I'm sure you're looking at the screen going, it's over there, you crazy old man. Come on, go look. You'll find it. It's right there. But I don't know. I'm going to go ahead and drink that. And if you click him again, you get more beers. And he says, uh-oh, he knows what's coming next. And you can get completely sloshed and basically just throw up off the roof, which we're going to do right now. So it's time for a click session. I'm going to click for beers, drink the beers, click for beers. He's not happy about what's going on. Click for beers, drink the beers, click for beers, drink the beers. So this is probably how much of a lightweight I am in the real world, IRL, if you will. Click the beers, drink the beers. I used to carry coffee around with me, because after you drink too much, you gotta sober up, and the graphics on the game get a little hazy, and your movements get a little stupid, and pretty soon you cast a spell called Drunken Vomit, which just launches hurl everywhere. It is pretty funny if you ask me. I think this might be the one that puts puts me over the top and puts all that down on these poor folks down here. Y'all are about to get it and you don't even know it. Such a fun thing for them to program into the game. That usually happens by now. I'm surprised it's not happening. This guy comes in really handy during, I want to call it Oktoberfest, but it's called Brewfest for the game. And man, this panda can take a drinking and keep on stinking. And I swear it's coming any minute now. The anticipation is killing me. Oh, here it goes. Oh. Yeah, they all get coated. Yeah. Disgusting. And now I'm mad stinking drunk and can't see straight. But that doesn't matter because we're going to use the user interface, the game interface, to access my fairly ridiculous pet collection, which I have a total of 1,121 pets. Of those, 1,093 are unique pets, meaning I don't have copies. Most of the copies I have are because I want a special team to fight the pet battles that are available. Let's just heal these guys up right now just to have them be in a nice healed spot. And hopefully this won't make too much noise when I move this microphone here, but it's slipping off just a bit. Get it a nice lockdown there. Okay, so what we have today is a bag full of stuff that got sent to me, which actually when I think about it, I need to fly down to, I just hit the ground. I'm so drunk I can't even fly straight. Grab these from one of my alts. Now for those of you that don't play the game, an alt is going to be something that is an alternate character that you play. And it mostly stemmed from getting to end game, getting bored, wanting to play a different role, even though you just mastered your role, or playing a role, getting bored before you mastered it, and saying, I want to play some other role. And you eventually find your niche, and find the character you want. As time went on, they started recognizing this in the development of the game, and they started putting, basically, not requirements, but achievements that you'd get for having alts and doing alternate work, really hardcore in Legion, where the class halls that they had, and they're being a pet lover. I still have to level a Dark Knight, a Death Knight. I still have to level, I need some bones, some stained bones to transmute a pet, so I'm going to need to do that here. Probably not tonight, I think I'll just go ahead and stick with what we're doing, but back to what I was saying. As an alchemist, you make pets in the game, and you know all the different classes and professions that you can use. They make different pets, and that is going to be something that gives you more pet count and unique pets that have special skills. There are others like this little guy that was extremely hard to get. I must have stood on top of a mountain, a plateau with a lake on it in the Timeless Isle, it's called, from Pandaria. Way too many hours. I mean, just not even wanting to admit exactly how bad it got. I was there a very long time. I could have bought it, but I think it was running for 300,000 gold, and I've never seen 300,000 gold, to be honest with you, except one time when my guild master loaned me a million gold to go get a pet and then give it right back to him, which just shows the level of trust that the guildmates that I have in me. They know I'm going to be good for some comedy, some humor, and they keep me around in a pretty top-notch guild as far as my main goes. So you might hear some scraping and rumbling. I've asked nicely for my family to please respect the fact that I'm trying to make these videos for you guys, but if you have family that doesn't have tingles, I'm sure you're used to this. They just don't understand. Non-tinglers don't get what we're doing, but you know what? We just gotta stick together and we'll get the tingles going. So, Garnia has some crazy abilities on the absorb and the bubble and the drain blood together. You will absorb people's power and give damage to them. You bubble, you will stop them from hitting you twice. The drain blood, you absorb a lot of their power and heal from them. So with these three together, you can just annoy the hell out of someone until they give up on the battle for the most part, unless they've got something that is good against elementals, which if you've ever played any animal battling games, you know, disclaimer, I do not promote Michael Vick sort of behaviors with animals. These are fake animals, things that don't exist. I would never say cockfighting, dog fighting, even rat fighting, you know, whatever exists out there. None of that's okay. Let those guys live. Let them do their thing. You know, don't mess with them. Make them fight each other for your pleasure. That's just, if you're into that sort of thing, get some peace, buddy. And there go the, you know, local base kids driving by with their doom 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 music. Oh well, yeah, I used to do that when I was younger. But oh my, I have gone way off the field. Anyways, if you've played any of those games, you know that, you know, water beats fire, that sort of thing. Similar in this, you've got a table with this add-on that will tell you if you're looking for something strong versus humans. You know, generally that's going to be, if I reset all those, humanoids are going to be weak to the undead. Strong versus dragon, that's going to be humans that will usually kill them. But every once in a while you get this specialty pet that can do these strange things that when you add the combos together, they just knock the crap out of somebody. For example, my machine right here, the Menagerie Custodian, he has a zap, a shock and awe, and an ion cannon. Now, when you hit him with this, if it's a beast, that just rocks their world. You got a 1 in 4 chance of stunning them so they can't make a move. And then you blast them with this ion cannon, and you have to cool down for a while. You're dazed. You have to recharge for 2 rounds. So you want to make sure to use that at the right moment, when you know the next couple of things they'll do are not going to be attacks on you. And then that will give you the ability to... that'll give you the ability to cool down and not get hit during that time. But, I mean, some of these guys can really just rock the world of the others. This is probably the number one pet in the game, the Anubisath Idol. When you cast this Sandstorm, half the time they can't even hit you. You recharge for... I don't know why, but 69 health points, or, you know, hit points, whatever you want to call them, HP, every round. And when you use that in combination with Crush, your punch is really hard. Deflection, it always goes first. So when you know they're about to do their big hit, you just hit Deflection, and they don't big hit you at all. So it's, you know, it's just one of those things that's, just makes him a really good pet. But what we have, if you've been looking through my bag at all, if you're not watching, that's fine. You know, this isn't really intended for you to use as a reference. This is just me rambling on about the things that I like to do. So you'll see that I've got an extreme amount of these different stones and these coins. My main, which is a horde hunter tauren called Ginishi, which... bastardized translation of Japanese from basically Google Translate was Silver Cow, because he's, you know, a silver cow. Pandoodles was just a goofy name I made up for a panda bear that was going to be... I hadn't decided at the time what I was going to do, but I thought, you know what? Maybe I'll go for the double agent achievement, which is quite a few points, and it means that you've leveled to the maximum level a character from both sides of the coin, the Horde side and the Alliance side. And that is what I did. And now I have the achievement. And I have this guy that I sometimes use to get Alliance business done and, you know, things like that. So, what shall we do? Well, I love this plugin because it helps me understand what we're needing to do with these different stones. So, a yellow stone will add 1 level to a battle pet in a specific family. This is the aquatic family. So what I would do is I'd go to my filter, and I would go to the, basically, the 15 to 24 range. Now the reason I want to do this is because leveling is super easy at 1, 2, 3. You get in one fight, and you level up to 2. Once you hit around 20 or 21, you got to do a few fights. Even at the maximum 25, you know, times 3 of the pet levels. You know, you get 3 pets, 25 each. Still doesn't level you up instantly. So you want to just go out and get one of these low-level battles done. And keep doing those. You want to do what's called pet carrying, which is you get a really low-level pet and 2 really strong guys. And they just go in and knock out the other guys. And then the little guy comes out and says, "Rawr!" And then goes back in his little corner. And then that's a... It sounds like a bit of a cheat, but it's just the strategy, in my opinion. And it levels them up way intense. Sometimes there's a buff that you get up here. That's a picture of a little critter. The little brown critter. And it's called the sign of the critter. When you have that, it means you get 200% the XP. So when that time comes around, which the calendar will tell you, you know what that is. It just passed recently. But there'll be another one in a month or so, probably. So I think it's going to be... when's the next sign of the critter? No, it may not be every month. Maybe every other month. No. No, I'd like to say, but... I guess it doesn't really matter. Anyways, so it comes once in a while. Pet battle bonus. It begins 7 a.m. on December Tuesday. I just have to clear my throat right quick. One moment. I'll turn that down a bit. And it happens then. There it is. Okay, so October the 15th, it'll be back again. And then it'll be over the next week. Pet battle bonus event ends, it says. So once that's done, you don't get as many points. But during this time... I level a bunch of guys up. So I go into this section, and I filter that to find that is aquatic. So I only want pet families in the aquatic that are level 15 to 24. So I've got a tide skipper that's a 21, and a puddle terror that's a 21. So they would need 4 apiece. I have 10 of these, so I'm going to summon the first one. It'll show up, and it seems I've sobered up a bit, so let's get off my little... dragon here, and I'll feed this guy 4 of these. And now he's off the chart, because he's a 25er. And then we're going to summon his little buddy, the Tide Skipper. And we're going to cast these on him. Now I have another level 25 pet. So, that is all of the aquatics that we have. Let's now switch to... pet family of beast. So I've got these. I was in kind of a goofy mood, so I would name the pets something silly or meaningful or a translation from another language. But after 600 or 700, I just kind of thought, blah, I'm really not interested in naming all these. So I don't think 19, 16, and 15 are really high enough to just feed a bunch of stones to, especially when I only have 2. So we're going to go ahead and hold off on that. Got to remember to bring these guys around for the battling during the pet battle bonus. Get them closer to 20. Maybe have some more of these stones available. And then when I do, then I can do what I did with the Tide Skipper and the whoever the other water guy was. So let's switch now to the next family of critter. So get off the beast and on the critter. I don't really have any critters at that level. I do have 12 critter stones. But with the next level being a level 14, I don't really want to do that. So we're just going to leave those stones and let them collect. Now, dragons. I've got a little bit of a problem with dragons. In that I've really leveled them, all the ones that I have, and there aren't that many dragons in the game. So I don't have anything I can level at all. All my dragons are max level. And because of that, which, you know what, I just realized I had an extra filter on. One of the reasons I'm a filthy casual is that I, you know, make little mistakes like that. So let's check the inventory again and see. Only looking at aquatic and only looking at level 15 to 24, there are quite a few more who could have benefited from this. Now, here's a 23 and here's a 23. These are uncommon. I don't like to level them unless they're the full rare blue. these can be caught in an area called Nazjatar. And so I'd really rather go back there someday and find the rares instead of upgrading the uncommons. So the next level would be this small frog named Konami. If you get the inside joke, good for you. The game Frogger was made by Konami, and that's why I named him that. But he will not be able to get up with that many stones to 25. You see these 49 down here? These allow me to add it to any pet. So I can make that choice to say, of those, I'm going to go ahead and summon this frog. And then I'm going to give him the 2 water stones that are left. Boom, boom. And then I'm going to give him the 1 it takes him to get the 25. So these you want to save for, you know, what ends are going to work best. Now, another kind of stone that I have is the fail-touched battle training stone. I've been collecting those for a while and just not using them. You really want to find a level 20 pet and boost them up with this. I like to look at which pets that I have based off of the families they're in. Now, I'm way behind on dragons because there just aren't that many dragons in the game that are easy to get. If I take the filter and reset it and put that to the pet family of Dragonkin and take a look at the ones that I do not have, there's only 6 I don't have in the whole game. And they're ones that are just kind of a pain to get. Timeless Isle. I've never done a lot of time walking, which is where you get these time walking badges. So I don't have 2200 badges. Can't get him. This guy is a drop from a really, really rare drop area. This guy right here, you had to buy the Cataclysm Collector's Edition. Ooh, that's got some really nice tingles to it. The Cataclysm Collector's Edition. Do you own the Cataclysm Collector's Edition? I don't own the Cataclysm Collector's Edition, because if I did, I would have a little Deathwing. Brought to you by the Cataclysm Collector's Edition. But I digress. Netherwhelp comes from the Burning Crusade Collector's Edition. You would have had to have bought that a very long time ago. They do sell them online for a very high price. If you go to eBay, then you'll find them for sale, and that will actually cause your divorce if you are married, or if you're rich, then whatever makes you happy. But yeah, I can't afford that sort of thing. Ysandra in the Nightmare, the Emerald Nightmare, extremely rare drop, always being sold for a ridiculous price on the auction house, but that ridicule is basically relative. It's a matter of opinion, because they got a rare drop. You want the pet, you're going to pay for it. Now, this guy, the oddly colored egg, was one of the first really weird Easter eggs that I think was tempting, I don't want to say hackers, but people who use utilities in the game to find things they shouldn't find, or, you know, just sort of tease the, you know, people who are looking around in the game code to see what the heck is that, what the heck is this. You have to do so many things for this guy. You're supposed to have this pug that you dress in a little fairy costume and, you know, do all these other things with, and you need to have all these specific potions, and if you don't have the potions, then you're not going to get past the level, and it's going to kick you out, and you're going to have wasted a potion. So, I mean, it's just such a hard pet to get if you do it wrong, or if you're just lacking the, you know, the character. I don't have the pug, because it's part of basically standing around requesting requesting dungeon runs with others, raids with others. I don't play that well with others on this game, because I make mistakes. My learning disability makes it hard for me to remember what I'm doing. So I don't really have the ability to keep up with the elites, and they tend to dislike me or call me a derogatory term for a hunter, kick me from the party, and that's just not an enjoyable experience for me. So I understand, guys, you're wanting to play your game, you're wanting to be elite. I don't belong in your crew. I'm sorry the developers made me do this to get this pet, and you despise what I am, but just trying to have some fun, and I really like this part of the game, so sorry to be in your playground, but I'm here. Now, let's get back to the business at hand. So, not a lot of dragons. Oh yeah, we've done that many years ago. Not a lot of dragons. Hello, learning disability. Not a lot of dragons in the game that you can get, so can't really level a lot of those. Next in line would be humanoids. Sort of a similar situation, so I'd look for humanoid, magic, undead, mechanical, and dragon. So if I were to go to the collected, and let's just reset this to be safe, I'm going to the humanoid, dragon, undead, magic, and mechanical. And I'm going to say level 15 through 24. I've got a knockoff Blingtron that needs leveling. Now since he's 20, he will benefit exactly 5 levels from this and be a level 25. I don't want to waste 2 whole levels on these guys, and I don't want to sort of get someone kind of close. So we'll get off the pet family thing by unselecting anything. You basically select everything. I don't really have any 20s, but I got a few 21s. That's a loss, I guess, I'm willing to call. But I have so many aquatic pets, it's really going to knock aquatic way up at probably past beast, which is the one that I had the most of. One a close second being critter. That was all things were in the beginning of the game, was critters. A companion was a critter. Then beasts started being a companion. And they started adding aquatics and flying. And then they started adding the others and not giving us as many of those. So, you know, it's easy to see how I could possibly be at these levels with the quantity of max level pets that I have. So, with that being said, I am going to... what choice should I make here? I know the Blingtron was boosted to 25. I don't want a lot of water pets. I do want a humanoid, but I'll lose 2 if I do that. And there's so many humanoid stones here. You know, I think it's just a matter of taking the time to take these level 19, 18, 17s, get them to level 20, and then throw the green stone at them. And I'm a very patient person, so I'm going to wait on that, and I'm not going to do it right now. So these will just wait right up here, out of my way. And I will now proceed to the... nothing I can do with dragons, so we'll look for the elementals. Sometimes I like to just wipe the slate clean because of that mistake I made earlier. I don't want to make that again. So I am going to wipe this clean, and we are going to get the elementals and see what we have to boost in the elemental family. So here we have elementals. Actually, that was strong versus pet family elementals we wanted. Here we have elementals. And we want to get that level down to 15 to 24. So we have quite a few. This guy deserves to be leveled. I've had him for a while. And I need to get him boosted up to where he's supposed to be. So let's just make the magic happen. And then this guy also, one of the guys I found on the Timeless Isle. Let's get him boosted. Alright. And we have another 8 of those. So that should be just enough for 2 more of these guys. So it's a matter of choice. This guy has an interesting set between the Blinding Poison and the Call of Darkness. So I'm going to go ahead and boost him up. Oh, he's a noisy guy. We have just enough for 1 more. I think with photosynthesis being in this guy's power... no, Shard of Siruk has Volcano. Frigid Frostling. I have someone else who does Slippery Ice and Ice Tomb with Ice Lance. Actually, I don't. This is one that I need to get boosted. So we'll summon him because he's going to be very useful. Alright, and he gets the last four stones. Fortunately, Ruby Sapling and Shard of Siruk will have to wait their turn. And now, as you see, my max level of elementals has gone up to 56. So, that means let's move on to the flying pets. So that should be easy enough. We go pet families, elemental off flying one. The Great Sea Albatross is not rare, so I don't want to boost him. The others are 18. I really don't want to go that route with them. So let's back off of that and check out the humanoids. The adventurous hopling. Oh yes, we need him in the fray here. He is a tough one too. An annoying drop option. And there he goes. And now my max amount of humanoids is 47 instead of 46. So here come the speeders. There go the speeders. We're going to get that magic battle training stone and check those guys out, see what they're up to. So we'll go to the magic, and we don't really have any of them. What are we looking at? Way down here in the 11s, 12s, 14s, not good enough. Going to have to really whip those guys out and get their pet battles going on. So no magics today, and let's talk about mechanical. Because I've got a heck of a lot of mechanicals. But when it comes to high or mid-level, no, when it comes to high level, I don't really want to boost 17ers with stones, even though I have 32 stones. It's just so much better to go do a battle, get them leveled up, and then, you know, get that out of the way. So, I can make another video where I'm showing the pet leveling that I do to get those pets up, and maybe that would be a nice little experience for us. So we'll leave those guys alone for now. And really, undead is all that's left, so let's switch the family to the undead family. Not a single one. So yeah, I really hoped this was going to be a big massive change, you know, in the amount of guys that I had, but just the wastefulness of throwing these stones at these guys when you could really just go into a, you know, basically a pet battle. This guy right here, I'm not a huge fan of Heroes of the Storm. I had to play quite a few rounds to get my character to 20. Funny story, I was trying to get a character to 20. Now in that game, you are your own level. Your characters are their own level. They level from 1 to 2 to 3 real easily. Then it starts getting harder and harder and harder. And I projected it saying, I can't get a guy at level 20. This is ridiculous. So I quit. I stopped playing that game. And then I got a little advice that, no, you need to be level 20. So get a guy to 3, walk away, get another guy to 3, walk away, 3, 6, 9, 12. And then finally when you're at 20, after your 7th one being at 21, or don't get him to 3, get him to 2, and boom, there you have it. Then they'll just drop this pet right in your bin, and sure enough, I came in, and here was Graves, just waiting for me to be used, or waiting to be used by me in a battle. So it's pretty interesting how some of these rewards work. But that rules that out, so I just really don't think that's going to be a big deal. I'm coming over here to the second screen, which I can't really show you because I'm recording directly through the game recording channel. But I told you my pet score was 6,231. When I go to manage, and then I update the collection with my most recent and re-import the pets, it now ranks me That's the same number I had before. Maybe I have to log to make that happen. But I don't know, we'll have to find out later. So, we've got some time to kill if we want to make this a nice, long video. And we could... Oh, is that what you want, Graves? No, he does want that. Alright, so what we'll do then is we'll take Graves and we'll level him up to a high enough level boosted by those undead stones and may not feel so guilty about it. Or better yet, you give him one of the greens and get him to 5, which, I don't know, I've got 28 of these, so I mean, it's so many decisions to be made. That import number hasn't changed, so maybe I have to log, probably so. 6231 was the number, still 6231, so yeah, it's not really registering that. Alright, so what to do now? Well, another thing about this, every time I see one of those guys, I want to turn into him. I have a little special mirror that lets me turn into anything I'm looking at in its current form. Oh, there he goes, he's running away from me. Get back here, you. I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna steal your powers. Make them mine. With my special mirror. Boom, now I'm you. Another fun thing that I can do is if I whip out a pet, doesn't matter which one. Let's just click for beers on this. I can get a beer and make him match me with the Narcissus mirror. So he should match my look. So now there's two of us. Come on, Junior. Let's go have a great time. Follow Daddy. Click for beers. And I can also boost his level. This is a kind of fun novelty thing to show to people, so I'm going to put him in a position where he's seen by others. And people see this dragon that says click for beers and they're like, what the heck? So let's make him more prominent by giving him a magical pet biscuit. And now you click this giant dragon for beers. And you get beer from a dragon. Drinking dragon, and we're having a grand time today with the drinking drunken dragon. Do you enjoy the drinking drunken dragon? I like the drinking drunken dragon. It's very nice to have a drinking drunken dragon. Have you ever had a party with a or not. Hopefully that was fun. Hopefully you didn't just get annoyed by it. It's so hard to know. I'm a very finicky tingler, and sometimes I suffer from ASMR immunity. One of the greats out there, old Uncle E, you know, in his channel, he has advised that he's lost the tingles. He hasn't got them for a couple of years, and that makes me very sad for him. You know, I want him to have that. It's a great gift to have. It's an amazing thing to have, that you can relax yourself just by listening to a sound, that you can be triggered like that. It's so wonderful, and we should look at that like this is something great. You know, I've had friends who say, oh, that's kinky, you're a weirdo, you know, what's wrong with you, man? They don't get it. They don't understand. You can't understand a thing you're not experiencing. It's just like, you know, people who do something else. Like, if you use any sorts of drugs, those give you an experience I don't get. I tried drugs, lots of drugs. You know, I went to college. Things were available to me. I had needs, friends and peer pressure, all that. And honestly, none of them ever really did anything for me. None of them did what they were supposed to do. And I think it's because my brain is wired so unusually after, you know, the things that happened to me when I was younger. I suffered a bit of a head injury. I was in a coma for a couple of days and woke up talking some serious nonsense about living in a dream world, Neo. And after that, I was kind of this unusual kid. It's not acquired autism. I've heard about that. I'm not obsessed with the thing. just weird guy, you know. What else can you say? I'm just a strange dude. I've had friends, and I've called them friends, but I've never really known that deep connection that some people have with a best friend. I've called people my best friend because they're the best I had. You know, there's always the best of something, even if they're not very good. If they're still the best of the worst, they're the best. So I've had people that I called friends. We would hang out together, but it was never that friendship, love. It was always just convenience, comfort, familiarity. Let's hang out with old George today and do stuff with him. And, you know, we're buddies, but then sometimes George would just be tired of me and he'd want to go hang out with his other friends. And in retrospect, I understand. I'm a very difficult person to be around and enjoy the company of when I'm not in one of my crazy, fun, silly guy making comments about all the crazy stuff at the store, you know, making you laugh sort of mood. So, you know, I always kind of, woe is me, looked at myself as a bit of a party favor. Yeah, I hung out with a lot of different crowds. I hung out with the choir people, the band nerds, the jocks, the, you know, all the different groups of people, the church kids. And they wanted me around because I made the party fun. I always livened things up. I always, you know, made little quips and little silly comments. Maybe you've caught some here and there. I haven't been trying to be funny on this. I just, if it's happening, it's happening by surprise. But I never really was someone's true best friend, best man at their wedding, you know, any of that. And maybe it's because I'm just not that reliable when it comes to, you know, needing someone like that. And it's just, that's just my way. I mean, it's just who I am. I'm different, but, you know, ever since that whole thing happened. So, you know, the drugs don't do anything for me. But if something does something for you, then you understand how it makes you feel. And I'm thinking, I don't get it. Same thing with ASMR. They don't get it. They don't get it because they don't get it. If you don't get it, you can't get it. You have to get it to get it. And if you don't get it, you don't get it. You get it? Okay. So that's the thing about ASMR. Explain all you want. Without proof, people are just going to think, what the heck is wrong with these people? Except the open-minded folks who say, okay, I see that it's a phenomenon. I see 1.7 million subscribers to Mr. Choi's channel while he eats a drumstick covered in spicy Cheeto dust. And I see that it's happening. So I'll say, okay, apparently it's something I don't get. But most people, they assess the world based off of their own views. And regardless of the proof against the fact that it's not that uncommon, they'll say, what a bunch of weirdos. What a bunch of freaks listening to somebody else eat. Or listening to somebody else talk in a different, deeper voice. Boy, those guys are just dumb. I don't understand that. Ugh. Okay, no one asked you to. You don't really need to come in and thumbs down every ASMR video. Because you're so mad it exists. You know, you need to just walk away. Let the community have what they need. Recognize it wasn't meant for you. And be gone. We'll all be happy. You'll be happy. We'll be happy. Everybody's happy. There's really no need for you to just come in and just dump all over all this stuff we're doing. But we all know they're out there. We all know the trolls are going to show up on the channel in the comments and say, ha, dorks, y'all are a bunch of weirdos. Yeah, I like to listen to my grandma eat beans too. Dumb. Okay, whatever. That's fine. That's your view. I've always been an advocate for freedom of speech. I will never think someone saying something is not something they should have the right to do. And I think it's our responsibility to deal with that. That's not a popular opinion these days. People want to have words used against other people be considered hate crimes. They're words. They're words. You need to remember what your grandma said. Sticks and stones may break my bones, but whips and no, it's that's wrong person. That was not my grandma. Okay, well, yeah, I don't know. Maybe it was. She always said a hard man is good to find. She was always kind of like that. There's a picture of my grandparents and my grandpa, who was a military judo instructor. He's just got his hands around her and giving her an old squeeze. And I'm just thinking, oh my gosh, you guys are crazy. But that's what they liked. If she was into it, he was into it. I guess that's why I'm here. Thanks for making mom, Grandma and Grandpa. But, you know, it's just one of those things. Okay, so I shrunk back down to my size. He's probably got just a little bit longer to go. I don't know how long Narcissus mirror lasts. I don't know that it has a different size. I could just lead this giant dragon all over the place and say, free beer from the giant dragon. Click him and get him. Who wants dragon beers? Dragon beers for sale. Hello. Anyone want dragon beer? Bunch of spear off. Come on. Who wants the dragon beers? Click for beers, baby. Get your dragon beer right here. Anyways, terrible accents. So, as I was saying before I so rudely interrupted my other self, this is gone, and I'll offer my apologies right now. If I ever trail off in the middle of a story and I don't finish it, please feel free to mention, dude, what happened with that thing you were talking about, and then somebody farted and ran by, and now I don't know what's going on because you had all that attention deficit hyperactivity disorder attack and ran for the hills and started following a bottle trader and not really understanding what's happening. Please finish your stories. You're gonna get that from me. Everyone gets that from me. I would apologize, but I'm just rambling here. I'm just trying to lull you to sleep. I sort of promised you that we would go level something up. I really prefer to level up by going to the Worgen, man who turns into a wolf. It's on the Alliance side. Once I get him up to level 100, which, if you know the game at all, you know that I could easily do that by coming here and choosing a 110 character boost for 60 American dollars, USD if you will. Let me say this in a nice, soothing voice so it doesn't let you feel any perturbation, if that's even a word. Feel me being perturbed. Hell no. I am not gonna spend that much money to boost a character. But when you look at your time and how much you make per hour, we so devalue our spare time. We so will do just the piddliest things that are worth so little with time that we value so much at work. $60? Let's see, I make that in about, what would that be, 3 hours maybe? Pretty close to that. And then when you talk about net, maybe like half a day. So that's like half a day's pay right there. Okay, so it's not that much. It's like a day's pay. We'll call it that. No, that would be, I don't know. I really don't know how to do my bills. My wife is a financial person, so she does the bills. So I'm probably talking out of my total butthole. But, let's just say, if I made $20 an hour, that's 3 hours of work. Taxes are X percent, so yeah, about half a day. Which, I don't think I make that much money, but anyways. Yeah, I'm really in touch with myself. I know. You know how much money I make. Way to go. I'm glad I have accountants and stuff. Because there's no way I could do any of that. It's just not part of the cards that were dealt to me with the crazy brain that you know that I have. So anyway, I'm not boosting a character that level, but I prefer to take the Death Knight, I got it, yes, and use him to go to these level up areas where he doesn't belong. He can be completely one-shot attacked and destroyed by a bird flying by, but I watch out on my, you know, screen. I make sure that I'm not in any areas where something could attack me. bonuses and level up my guys. And they get pretty fat XP off of that. I don't know how to get any of the other things out of this that I want. Yeah, I just totally lost my mind there. I don't know how to get the... I'm drawing a blank here. I was going to say, let's do this together. Let's backtrack and see what I can find about this. I don't know in this area how to carry pet on any of these battles. I do know how to plan strategies, so maybe I can figure one out. I can find a pet battle that's available. There seems to be one where a little piggy has sharp tusks that's available. That must be new because I don't remember seeing it before. Oh, you know why? Because I was only looking for coins. There's a coin one in Drustvar. I can probably do that. So let's go to Fletcher's Hollow in Drustvar. And unfortunately I lost my click for Beer's Dragon by doing that, but that's okay. So we're going to go to that area, and we are going to, I'm totally lost here, okay, going to see if we can get a little score off of that. I don't think the world quest options have a lot of that, so keep the wind in your sails, mate. I don't think they have a lot of level up abilities. So I'm just going to have to find out the hard way. And see what I get from this. This moment of silence is brought to you by your friends at What Is Going On in That Guy's Brain. Pops, get your stuff together. Think about things before you say them. It's not going to help. If I had a script, I could read off of it. But life is not scripted, man. It's improv. You gotta roll with the punches on improv. So when we get to this guy, what we're going to do is we are going to try to find a way to level up Graves. So let's go ahead and find him on this battle inside of this list. So that would be in Culturus. And I believe they said that was the Battle of... Okay, you're too loud. Shut your mouth. Thank you. Man, I might have to tune the whole thing down just because of her. But the battle we're talking about here... I am drawing a blank from this because... It is Night Horrors with Dilbert McClint. So we are going to go into the Night Horrors... Dilbert McClint, and we are going to use the, I'm all over the place, Dilbert McClint, okay, let's go load his team, which is already loaded apparently, and then I'm going to find Graves, and I'm going to put him at the tail end of this, so I'm going to bring him in first. I don't know what I'll gain from this. I want to say that they nerfed these so that they can't really give you a lot of extra skills, but there's only one way to find out. Well, there's research, but let's not go into that camp. There's other ways to find out, but let's use this way since that's what's available to us. So I go into this battle, click on him. Yeah, good day to you too. I wish you had talked more quieter, sir. We're doing a very peaceful, quiet thing. So I'm gonna clobber this guy. And he just spat acid on me. So I'm going to leave that. And he's going to be all confused back there. That guy goes under the ground. So I'm going to go ahead and pass my move. Because he'll just miss when he pops up. I'm going to hit him with this. Alright, so missiles. As you see, they're beast, and I am machine, mechanical. So this green arrow shows up because he's a beast. And that means my hits are going to hit him hard. Now, when I have this spinning confusion over my head, it's not going to happen. So I'm just trying not to waste this. He's barely put a dent in me. Not going to do a thing to me. Spoke too soon. So now I'm down a little lower. This guy has some powers that really aren't going to keep me from doing anything. So I'm going to shoot him once. A mechanical creature is allowed to respawn one time with limited health. That's their trait. So if I shot this and he did a little hiss on me and killed me, I wouldn't have a second chance. So I'm just going to go ahead and take the hit, die, res, and call lightning from the sky and kill that guy. Well, now I'm recovering for the next two rounds. So that guy hisses me out of existence, and away he goes. But I bring in this guy, and then I'm going to attack with that shock and awe. Got him down to 1054, which adds about 4 more than I'd be able to do, so I'm going to zap him one time, since he's out cold. Check his options and make sure he doesn't have anything that'll make him hide from me, and just obliterate him. And now Graves comes out and collects 208. So yeah, I mean, you used to get a lot more off of these, but they stopped doing that. The good news is they left them intact on the older games. So in a future video, what we will do is we will go ahead and go to that place with my Morgan, and we will go ahead and do some leveling up to get those pets up, and then we'll come back on as Pan Doodles. And we'll do the leveling that we need to do. And that's what we can do for that time. So, in the meantime, I guess we are just going to say that's a farewell. And give you a little bit of this action going on. Oh, for goodness sake. I'm not a director. I'm just trying to say goodbye to you all. How smooth am I? I want to go Alt-Z to make the screen disappear, but I can't. Well, I'll show you one thing I could do that I hadn't thought of. I could come up with a macro that gives us a few minutes. So we go to macro, and we say new, and we just pick something at random. Let's just say goodbye with, no, that's one of my other ones, so let's, yeah, I really don't want to put too much thought into this. Let's just grab something that's like, I don't want to put too much thought in it, but I'm doing it anyways. Here, there's a hand. Okay, so we'll call that goodbye. And then we will say, okay, we'll make that say goodbye. And then save it. And now I have this. But if I want to do it with the screen off, I have to make it, let's make it N6. So now I can give you a proper goodbye with the use of a macro. We'll Alt-Z to take that off the screen. And I want to bid you all a farewell. And a good night. And if you're not asleep already, I hope you will be soon. I apologize for any extra noise in the background, a couple of bangs here and there. I'll see what I can do to take them out. If you were subject to any of those, c'est la vie. I don't have a studio that is soundproof against the world. I will do what I can to give you the quietest experience possible. But I do live in a major city with a lot of people making a lot of noise. But we're going to call that a done deal. And I'm going to say farewell.
Next time, I'm buying.
Good night.